Gaffer, just thought we'd let the Celtic fans get to know you, so we'll just ask you a few questions about your time in football and stuff like that.
What professionally?
Both.
First, as a kid, it was just at the local youth centre, when I was about 8 years of age. And if it was professional, it would have been as a first year pro at Cardiff, so around 18, I think. Do you know what? I should have known from that. I think it might have been, it was the Coca-Cola Cup then, which was probably like the League Cup, and it was against Portsmouth. I'm sure that was my first start. Long time ago. Oh. As a player, in terms of
just
the standards,
just stands out.
Probably my first start for Wales, because it's like, you know, the pride of that and what it meant to me and the whole achievement of that and the fact that we were playing Brazil away just put so much icing on the cake of that. So to start for Wales anywhere would have been unreal for me, but for that first start, I'd been capped before that, I'd come off the bench, but for my first start to be in Brazil, it was just like, you don't get any better than that. That was the peak.
Was that best ground you've ever played in as well?
I wouldn't say so. The occasion and everything it was, and it was the, I think we played about 99 maybe before. It was in between World Cups. I think they'd lost to France, whatever year, when did they lose to France in the World Cup? Maybe 98?
Yeah.
And we played them in between that and the next World Cup, but it was a good team and great ground, but I wouldn't say the best. I mean, played at Old Trafford and places like that, but Anfield as a Liverpool fan as a boy, Anfield was the best place to play. In terms of stadium, I don't know, all fantastic sort of stadiums. As a kid, I went to watch Wales beat Germany in a Euro qualifier at the old Cardiff Arms Park, which is now the Millennium Stadium. Just a gang of us from school, and that was amazing. Ian Rush scored the winner, we won 1-0. And it was first experience, you know, the full stadium and the atmosphere and all that kind of stuff. Must have been about 14. That was brilliant. And I took my two lads, Morgan and Dylan, to Liverpool beating City in the quarterfinal, was it, the Champions League the other year? That was just an unbelievable day. Met up with Jono, who's now assistant. Went for a full day out, and then the game, you know, perfect performance, perfect atmosphere. That was an impressive sort of game to go to. Everybody knows this part, don't they? Lord Huron, band from Michigan in America, sort of folk rock kind of band. I think they're brilliant. Been to watch them a few times, lucky enough to have met them and kept a bit of contact there. There's a bit of friendship, which is unbelievable. I've never been sort of starstruck in life, but I was with them, and I just think they're unbelievable, and I'm very fortunate to still have some contact with them, really, as they've become successful. As a kid, probably Ian Rush, being Welsh and playing for Liverpool. I've been a centre forward, scoring goals at 8, 9, 10. Ian Rush was probably the one. He was a phenomenal sort of goal scorer, he was the best. And that was that one. And I liked Romario and Ronaldo as a teenager, you know, the two Brazilian ones. They were both sort of super players as well.
I've never ever used a Bassi.
No. Playing, not managerial really, you're a bit out there on your own, I'd say. I've just taken bits from managers I've worked with, and players. You know, I played with some players who are now good managers, Roberto Martinez, Michael O'Neill at Stoke, you know, both good friends who I played with have gone on to do really well, so I try and tap into some of their thoughts and how they do things from when we, you know, play together, or in mixed case when we used to drink together in lock-ins in Lim, when we lived in Lim. So more of that really, and managers, good managers, you know, Gordon Strachan was a good manager, Mark Hughes, people like that, whereas since I've started managing, Mickey Mellon, when I worked at Shrewsbury as a coach there, learned an awful lot off him and Jacko, an awful lot. So he'd probably be the one I would tap into at the moment if I wanted something. He's done brilliant at Tranmere and out Dundee United. Michael O'Neill probably. Not for being daft, but just sharp. Very, very funny man. He's spent a lot of time with him at Coventry and Wigan, and we both lived in Lynn together. We were always in the club having lock-ins and spent a lot of time with him, but just witty, sharp, he'd cut you in half sharp, you know, not daft. I know there's daft lads out there who drive golf buggies up the motorway and stuff, but not that kind of stupid, just a funny man. Like. Different ones again. Cardiff was my hometown club, meant a lot, and it was a huge club, Cardiff, and I just think the whole playing for them and, you know, living in the city centre and that kind of stuff, huge from that point of view. Coventry was a Premier League club, so it was big in that sense, that it was a Premier League club, playing with Premier League players. Wigan was different, as in we were at the start of the journey with Dave Whelan, and they've gone on to do all the things he promised, so I take great pride in, you know, scoring the first goal of that stadium, first hat-trick, being part of that journey, that's a real story. And Tranmere was a traditional, proper football club with great, great fans, so different memories of all of them. I wouldn't like to pick, just different experiences of all of them. I know I'm sitting on the fence, but they all offered different experiences for me. Via Clitheroe, pre-season, first season. I think the first game in the season was at Clitheroe, and that was Ossett Albion away, and drew 2-2 from being 2-0 up. So that's probably the right answer, yeah. Well, I mean, I've only been managing 4 years. I've 2 years at Clitheroe and 2 years at Stalybridge. Probably the best in terms of performance was beating Colne away. Plenty of rivalry with their manager, Steve Cunningham. They were local rivals, and it was probably the perfect performance. We played them on Boxing Day, and it's similar to the Stalybridge Hyde one. You know, Boxing Day, it's a proper game, proper derby, and we went to their ground, both in and around the playoffs, and beat them 6-0. And I don't think it'd take a good while for me to win a derby game against a local rival in their backyard. It'd take a while to beat that problem. Although Hyde last year was fantastic, but I'm just thinking of, you know, 6-0s.
Yeah.
Manage as high as possible. Yeah, I think I'll try and do that for a period of time. If I feel like stagnate, I wouldn't want to go backwards on it. I wouldn't spend time managing, no disrespect, in this league or the league below or below that forever. I would probably go and maybe make a lifestyle choice and try and manage abroad or coach abroad. I've always fancied working in America. So I think once I've given this a good go, if I was to stand still or go backwards, I'd probably go and try and manage abroad or coaching abroad, and America would probably be my first choice. So I'd probably make a decision to spend more time on the beach in the sun. Michael O'Neill, because we had some good times and I've not caught up with Mick for a little while. Think of who else I'd want, really. Maybe the Brazilian Ronaldo, I think, because he was just a super player. I want to tap into that. And probably one of the great Liverpool managers that's gone, so probably someone like Bill Shankly. So there's a bit of everything there. Someone who's achieved that, being a sort of Liverpool fan, a good friend in football, and someone who I was probably the best player I've seen. Jono to cook for me, straight away. No chance, be a bowl of scouse. I wouldn't want Jono to cook for me. I wouldn't want a lot of players in our team to cook for me. I think of another bad one. Tom Wilson would be a bad one. That wouldn't get done correctly by any stretch. Jono first and Tom Wilson second. Hard one again, some good players, and it's a short career. I've only been doing it 4 seasons. I'd probably have to say on what they've achieved, it'd have to be Alex Newby, who this year has gone to Rochdale, started pre-season great. Brilliant kid. I got all over the time for Al because we signed him released from Bolton. He was at Barrow. Barrow had released him, and he was travelling from Barrow and Furness to Clitheroe 3 times a week, and it's about 2.5 hours. Sometimes we might have Ghoul away on a Tuesday night and he'd have another 2.5, and his dedication to that was unbelievable. First year, he needed the games, and we had our moments, and I spent a lot of time coaching and working with him and giving him good advice. Second year, he took off, done really well, went to Chorley, stepped up again, and now he's found himself in League One, so I'd have to say him on that. I have to give a few mentions to Kurt Willoughby, could do the same. Kurt's got the potential to do that. Kurt was a great lad, dead enthusiastic, good goal scorer. And Darius, who we had last year, say was similar, another player that could and should be playing a lot higher. So them three would be the ones, but Alex would be top of that. And I've never had them really on me. I've had the just the standard ones, the taping cars up and that kind of thing, you know, and stealing cars, moving cars, cutting clothes.
Has anyone ever done one to somebody else that you thought was brilliant?
Yeah, last year's I think was good. Hobbo, I'm naming names here. Hobbo and Deck and his little crew doing it to Valo, moving his car and taping it up last year was pretty good. And that happened in pro football all the time. If you had a good set of lads and a good team spirit, but it was cutting clothes up, and you know, in pro football people could afford good things. It was designer clothes and pretending to steal their car, that kind of sort of kit really, but all good fun.